Hey everyone, Daniel from Twin Bytes with another tutorial for you. This time in this video, I'm going to show you how to disable the Avast antivirus firewall on your computer. There are several reasons that you might want to do that, and disabling the firewall might not help. There's a couple other things you can do up to and including uninstalling the antivirus completely. So I'm going to show you how to do that. You'll see the antivirus down in the bottom right corner of your screen by your time, and the icon for Avast actually changed recently. You would go into the protection tab on the left, and then you'll see firewall down here you can go into, and there's a green check beside firewall. You would just uncheck that, and then you have the option of either stopping it for just 10 minutes, which in my opinion may usually not be enough time for you to test it properly. So 1 hour can be enough, but then if you want to really have more full control over it, you can either say stop until you restart, and then it'll just turn itself back on the next time you restart the computer, which at that point the issue may come back and then you forgot that you had the firewall disabled for it to work, or stop indefinitely, and that would be a temporary issue for you to get around it, troubleshoot it, and try and get it to the point where you can actually work with the computer and get the issue resolved while still having the firewall turned on. So we would say stop indefinitely for now. Are you sure? Okay, stop. And then you'll see it's got a red X over it. If we look at the main status screen, it does give you a reminder from here that the firewall is turned off. So you can turn it back on right from here simply by clicking that green button that says turn on, and then the computer is protected again. Now, if that didn't resolve the issue disabling the firewall, there are a few more things we can look at real quick. Let's jump in. With the antivirus open, go into protection again, and this time we're looking at the core shields. You'll see there are several types, and it could be one or more of any of these things here. So we would go into the settings here, and here's where you can turn off the core shields. Clicking this button here will disable all of them, and again you have the option to choose how long you want to stop these for. And then that's got a red X, or a red circle with a white X if you want to be technically correct. And then you can see there are many other options in here as well. So you can choose which ones you want to enable. So maybe the file shield is fine and we want to leave that on, but it's only the behavior shield. So what we'd have to do is turn this back on and then come down here, and we'll leave the file shield on. The behavior shield might be an issue, so you might want to disable that, and you'd have to play with these to really see which one might be the cause of the issue. I'm limited with the option that I have on here because this particular program is a cloud care version, so it's managed and monitored from the cloud, so I'd have to go into my cloud portal to make changes on some of these things. But for you, you would be able to uncheck individually which ones that are the problem, or between some of the other sub options you can see down here, you can enable and disable as required. So you would just play with those features until you get that resolved. And if you're still having problems with the firewall and the core shields turned off, then the next step would be to uninstall the antivirus completely and then reboot the computer. And at that point, if you're still having problems, then you need to start troubleshooting further into that particular software that you're having the issue with. And if you found this video helpful, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.